Looks like we are ready for our first dog competing in this class. This is our biathlon agility class. This score will be combined with the score from the agility, biathlon jumping class that was held previously this weekend. This is Christine Redeker with Giddy Up. They are coming into this class in fourth with a 43.29. She is clean so far. And a finish time of 45.62 with a clean round. So her final score in this class is 45.62. Next on the line, we have Rhea, a toy poodle being handled by Natalie Winter for Australia. They have a no score from the jumpers class. So Natalie did save that off-course potential. I think they're still clean. I got a little distracted. I had a different dog first on the line and had to search through my paperwork to find out what we were doing. So Natalie and Rhea are going to post a score of 43.60. Online, we have Batman, a Papillon, being handled by Jamie Moreau from Canada. Batman had a score of 49.66 for the jumpers round. And added to that will be a 54.86. Time plus fault scoring in the biathlon agility class. And that'll be added to their jumpers round. Again, I'm probably not going to be able to do the math for you guys. I will try to keep track of the faults and the time for you in this class. And try to point out what their seed was coming in. On course, we have Storm with Kevin Burnett from New Zealand. They were also a no score on the jumpers round, so this score will be added. Darcy Bennett is our judge. He's going to call that a fly off today. And also flag the downside dog walk contact. So we'll have 10 plus a time of 47.93. Two course faults equals 10 added to the time of 47.93.
Ready.
Next in the ring, we have Oscar Gonzalez with Mika the Papillon for Team Mexico. Refusal fault called by the judge. That'll be added to his course time of 45.85 plus 5 for a total score of 50.85. On the line, we have Andy Mueller with Crackers, Jack Russell Terrier for Team USA. Andy and Crackers are third seed coming into this class with a previous time on the jumpers round of 41.37. Got that threadle pulled on, and this is a fairly tricky weave entry. He chose that left turn into the tunnel. Nice running dog walk. Oh, we had time to get a front end. Very nice. That is a clean round, very well done. That's a 37.54, and that is his final score. Next on the line is Deneen Fox with her Papillon Masher for Team USA. Just disconnected on that threadle pull. Deneen and Masher is a 41.15. Next on the line, we have Asuka with Masanori Arai for Team Japan. They were first ranked with a time of 40.35. Faulted the downside dog walk. All right, looks like they finished their run with five faults and a 54.48 for a total score of 59.48. On the course, we have Louie, a toy poodle, being handled by Kate Bartles for Australia. They are clean through this course with a 52.47. Our next dog in the ring is Cube, a Papillon, being handled by Chi Fukui, and they are fifth coming into this round. Their previous time was 43.49. That's their time plus fault on the jumpers round.
We have three dogs left to go in this fight. We need our two-inch mini dogs checking in for this. Three two-inch dogs to the arena.
Are through that course with a 44.14 plus 5 for a 49.14. I'm not sure I can keep all of that straight. On course, we have Peter Wabbit with Christine Redeker for Canada. I do have a time to beat for this class. This is, again, our biathlon jumpers. It's a 37.54, turned in by Andy Mueller and Crackers. Finish the course with a 46.25. Two more dogs in our toy division. This is Cookie, Pembroke Welsh Corgi, with Tomoko Yamashito from Japan. Finished the course with no faults and a 46.74. Our last dog in the toy division took a second place in the biathlon jumpers class with a time of 41.28. This is Dana Pike with Tangle USA. Tangle are clean through that course with a 36.99. So we do have some results from this class for our toy division, the biathlon agility. In first place, it looks like Tangle with Dana Pike from USA. Second place is Andy Mueller and Crackers USA. And third place is Natalie Winter with Rhea for Team Australia. We are moving on to our midi dog division. Those are our dogs jumping 16 inches. Oops, take that back. Looks like 22 inch. Midi division is next. That's our 22 inch dogs. We're ready for our first dog in the midi division. This is Pisco, being handled by Yuki Araki. They were in eighth place after the biathlon jumping competition with a time of 39.48. Like a clean round with a very nice time of 34.16, and that is added to his previous score of 39.48. Our next dog to the line is Stony, being handled by Ricardo Calvillo for Mexico. They were a no score from the jumpers class. Judge flagging the downside dog walk on that. That's his second fault on course. And again, we're scoring this class time plus faults. So Ricardo and Sony wind up with a 51-59 plus 10 for a total score of 61-59. On course is Carrie Nielsen with Josephine for Team New Zealand. They were a no score from the jumpers round as well. Just pulled her in time for that tunnel entry. Like they're going to put in a clean round with a time of 39.25 for Josie and Carrie. On the line, we have Kevin Burnett with Gorgeous for New Zealand. Just clipping that first bar. Now they're all looking at that A-frame when they come through that wrap. There's so much yardage, they're looking for something to do. Their round with a 39.98, and I believe 15 course faults will be added to their score. 39 plus 15. The dog in the ring is Slice with Kale McCann, Team Canada. They were in ninth place coming into this round. Her previous time on the jumpers round was 42.22. And got signaled for a refusal fault. Another refusal fault. And a third. Oh, she's disappointed. She did a great job on this course. 40.57 plus 15. Our current leader for this round is the first dog right out of the gate. That was Pisco with a 35-16. On course now, we have Vincent de Tavernay with Incho from Belgium. Through this round with a 39-45. To the line we have Adrian Royakers with Fizz for Canada. They were in the seventh spot after the biathlon jumpers class with a 37-92 score. faulted on that downside dog walk. Oh, a little bit of dancing from Adrian. Didn't quite make it. Got a refusal fault on that. Second to the last jump. So we're going to add 10 faults to his score of 39.89. On the line now is Jeanette Hutchison with Rumble for Team USA. She is third seed coming into this class, and her jumper's time was a 32.65. Through that round clean with a 34.5. That's our new leader on this for this class, Jeanette and Rumble with a 34.5. On the line is Denise Crook with Easy for Team Australia. Oh, just couldn't get that turn done and crossed the plane of those weave poles for an off course. Next dog in the ring is Ian Weston with Elf from Australia. So the rules on our breakaway tire is as long as the breakaway tire doesn't open, it is not penalized. Oh, that blind cross. Little misread from Alf. Didn't quite know where to go. And Ian and Alf are going to finish this class out. Very well done. 40.71.
Our next string instructor down. This is Matsukoi Yamamoto and Pose.
Our next dog on the line is Pose, handled by Masaka Yamamoto. They are in fourth place coming into this class, posting a time on the jumpers round of 34.72. This round with a nice time of 37.66.
Now our representative from Puerto Rico, this is Annette Alfonso at Legend.
Next on the line is Annette Alfonso with Legend from Puerto Rico. Refusal fault. Just cut the corner of that broad jump. She's going to go back and fix it. That's just 5 seconds added to her time. And they will finish the course with a 43.70 plus 5 for a 48.70. So the time to beat on this course right now is the 34.90 posted by Jeanette Hutchison and Rumble. On course now we have Vixen with Bronwyn Burnett for Team New Zealand. She worked hard to get that. We lost the course. Just yes, these New Zealand handlers and the Australian handlers have done a great job working through these courses with someone else's dog. Never an easy task. And they're going to finish their course with a 57.14. On the line, we have Kim Cullen with her Border Collie Recess. They are from Canada. She is our top seed coming into this round. Her previous time on the jumpers course was a 32.62. I think we've got a little bit of an equipment thing going on here. Looks like we didn't have the right scribe sheet. Our scribe is back in place. Kim's taking the line. Nice pull, and she is clean through the, oh golly! Recess says, I'm overjoyed, just missed the jump, and she is posting a 35.41 on that round. That was a really pretty run. On course, we have Ricardo Cavilla with Math, a Border Collie from Team Mexico. They were in 11th place coming into this round with a 50.44 from the jumpers class. That was Ricardo and Math posting a nice run at 49.27. And on the line now, we have Sweet being handled by Dudley Fontaine. They were fifth after the jumping round with a posted time of 34.95. Through the course with a 35.98 for Dudley and Sweet. So on the line we have Fiona with Oscar Gonzalez from Team Mexico. They were sixth seed, that's number six, coming into this round, and their score from the jumping class was 36.17. Oscar and Fiona do a nice job of finishing out that round. 42.75 on the clock. Coming into the ring is Stuart Ma with Aries. They are representing Team USA. They were second seed after the jumping round with a posted score of 32.63. He's got a little bit of time to make up with that confusion between the three and four. They are clean with a 34.72. So our next dog on the line is Testarossa with Nikki Maura for Japan. They were 10th seed coming into this class. Their jumping score was a 44.27. Testarossa are going to finish the course with a 35.53 plus 5 for a 40.53. And our last dog in the midi jump height division is Gabby, being handled by Damien Naud for Australia. Thank you. We are ready for our mini dog division. These are our 16-inch jumping dogs. First on the line is Dune, being handled by Lucy Robertson. They were third coming out of the jumping class with a total score of 35.74. Lucy and Dune finished that class with a 38.64 plus 5. Next on the line is Kevin Brown with Hunter. They are fourth seed coming into this class, and their jumping score was 36.25. And they are clean through that course with a 37.92 for Hunter. On the line, we have Bronwyn Burnett with Reebok, the Sheltie from New Zealand. And they are clean through that course with a 44.96. Next in the ring is Annie Vazina with Mech, the Shetland Sheepdog from Canada. And they will finish this course clean with a 46.44. In the ring now, we have a miniature poodle by the name of Lemon, being handled by Asao Agame. Thank you. They finish out the course with a 40.63 plus 5 for a 45.63. Next on the line is a toy poodle named Alfred, also Team Japan, being handled by Atsuko Nagasaki. Alfred will finish this course with a 44.86 plus 5 for a 49.86. On the line, we have Jean LaValle with Shetland Sheepdog Cheer. They come into the ring with the top spot for the agility jumping round, and their previous score was a 34.39. Through this course with a 36.50. And 36.50 is our new time to beat for this class. 36.50 is our new time to beat for the 16-inch dogs. In the ring now, we have maybe a miniature poodle being handled by Masayuki Watanabe. Finishes the course with a 46.54. 46.54. In the ring now is our second seed dog. This is Mikkel with Maureen Waldron. They posted a 34.65 on the jumpers round earlier in the competition. Just missing that weave entry. Are going to finish this course with a 41.65 plus 5 for a 46.65. Next in the ring is Sally, a Shetland sheepdog being handled by Fernando Batista. Is clean through this course with a 45.42. Next on the line, we have Nicole Ford with Rodeo, the Shetland sheepdog for Team Australia. They are fifth seed coming into this round, and their posted score for jumpers was 43.16. So Rodeo and Nicole get through this course with a 39.77 plus 5 for a 44.77. Next in the ring, we have Billy O'Connor with Sonic, the miniature poodle for Australia. Finish that round with a 44-48, but it is a no score for the off-course penalty. Next in the ring, we have Siegfried Cleaver with Neve, the Shetland sheepdog for Team Australia. They are in the sixth position coming into this round. So this is Meave on course. They were in the sixth spot coming into this round with a 44.41 out of the jumpers class. And they are going to post a score of 44.22.
Our last competitor for this night is Linda Oyelowo.
Next in the ring, we have Linda Orton-Hill with Favor for Team Canada. Favor are clean through that round with a 38.62. All right, we are resetting our course for the next jump height. It looks like it's going to be our maxi dogs. That's our 26-inch jump height. I do have some unofficial results from this biathlon standard agility class. It looks like, Cheer is in first place with a 36.50. Hunter and Kevin Brown in second place with a 37.92. And Favor with Linda Orton-Hill in third place with a 38.62. This is the start of our 26-inch jump height division for biathlon agility. On the line is Carrie Nielsen with Journey from New Zealand. Carrie and Journey are going to post a score of 43.37 plus 10 for a 53.37. In the ring, we have Robbie, a Labrador Retriever, being handled by Tamika Tanabe. They are 10th seed coming into this class, and their previous score posted in the jumpers class was a 39.96. Robbie and Tamiki are going to post a 41.58 plus 5 for a score of 46.58. Next on the line is Fred Waters with Tanafon. Canadian Dog. They are sixth seed coming into this class with a previous score of 37.78. Fred and Tanafon are going to get through this course with a 38-48 plus 10 for a 48-48. Next on the line is our top seed dog. This is Nevion with Anna Eifert. Their previous score in the jumpers round was a 31.63. And she is Team Hungary. Super job, 35.30 for a final score of 35.30. On the line is Bosco with Raul Laguna from Mexico. Saved it. Saved that last one. 45.22. And I think we have 10 added to that. I'm not sure, but we're somewhere in that vicinity. On the line, we have Deb Jackson showing Border Collie paint for Team New Zealand. Past the entry, snuck past Deb. So this is Deb Jackson, with paint. Posting a 46.53 and a no score on the off course tunnel. Now Next on the line, we have Tony Redwood with Zeke for Team Australia. So Tony and Zeke are going to get through this course with a 39-7-8 and a no score for the off-course elimination. Next on course, we have Vetter, a Belgian Malinois being handled by Osvaldo Duran. They are in 11th seed position, coming out of the jumpers class with a 45.25 on their previous run. With a 42.66. Spritz is on the line with Andrea Gibney for Team Australia. So Spritz and Andrea finished the course with a 42.01, 42.01. And I'm sorry I didn't watch the Spritz round to see whether there were faults added to that round or not. I'll let you guys do that at home. On course is Maverick with Dudley Fontaine. They are in fourth position coming into this round with a 36.500. Through this round with a 35-54. Dudley and Maverick turn in a 35-54. Next on the line, we have Susan Garrett with Feature for Team Canada. They are in the fifth spot coming into this round. Their previous score posted for the jumpers class was a 36.508.
Yeah.
And just clipping that bar. That's a 34.76 plus 5 for a 39.76. On the line, we have Graciela Calderon with her Belgian Malinois Nahomi. They are in 12th seed coming into this class with a previous score of 46.68. Graciela and Naomi finished the course with a 52.76 plus 5 for a 57.76. Our current leader in this class is still Nevion with a posted score of, well, I may not be right on that. Hang on, I'm gonna re-verify that. In the ring, we have Yuki Faruki with Fuga for Team Japan. Are going to finish their course with a 37.12 and a no score for the off-course elimination. We have a little judges conference out there. Let me recap what I have so far for the 26-inch dogs. I do have Nevion and Anna Eifert from Hungary in the top spot so far, followed by Maverick and Dudley Fontaine with a 35.54. And it looks like the third spot is currently Susan Garrett with Feature and a 39.76. On course, we have Rio. This is a Border Collie being handled by Tiffany Salmon. They are in the third spot coming into this class. Her previous posted time on the jumpers round was 36.41. Course with a 40.43. Our next dog in the ring is Jill, a Border Collie, being handled by Siochu Yamashita. And they are in the 13th spot coming into this class with a previous score of 52.17. Yeah. And that is Jill finishing up her course with a 37.75 plus 5 for a 42.75. On course is Lord Zoran, being handled by Saskia van Stielend from Belgium. They are 8th seed coming into this round. Posted time on the jumpers class is a 38.31. With a 34.67 plus 5 for a total score of 39.57. Next in the ring, we have Lace, being handled by Kelly Cleanwear. They are from Belgium and 9th seed coming into this course. Posting a jumping score of 38.45. Done. They are through this course clean with a 37.03. In the ring, we have Bronwyn Burnett with Grissom, the Border Collie, from New Zealand. And that is Bronwyn and Grissom finishing the course with a 48.10 and an unfortunate no score for the off-course penalty. Next in the ring, we have Vic, being handled by Mia Grant. They are Team USA. She is second seed coming into this class, posting a jumper score of 34.50. With a nice time of 37.38. Two more dogs to go in our 26-inch jump height division. This is Terry Schmorch with Presto for Team USA. They are 7th seed going into this round with a posted score of 37.82 from the jumpers class. nice round for Terry and Presto. Clean with a 35.73. And our last dog on this course is Dandy, being handled by Natalie Kirkwood. This is Natalie and Dandy posting a nice time of 40.41 plus 5 for a 45.41. We are getting ready to award the Agility Biathlon winners, starting with the Maxi Dogs. In third place, we have Maverick with Dudley Fontaine for Team USA. Second place is Mia Grant with Vic, USA.
And first place, Joanna Eifert and Levia.
And first place goes to Anna Eifert with Evian, Team Hungary. They will take the podium for the medal presentation. And now the national anthem for Hungary. Congratulations to all the medalists for the biathlon competition in the Maxi division.
And now the Mini division.
Now we will award the Mini Midi. Mitty Dog. This is our 22-inch jump height. In third place, we have Kim Cullen with Recess for Team Canada. Second place goes to Rumble with Jeanette Hutchison, Team USA.
First place
goes to Aries and Stuart Ma, USA. Our medal presentation for the Mitty Dog Division. Next up, the Mini Dogs. 16-inch jump height. In third place, we have Lucy Robertson with Dune from Canada. Second place is awarded to Kevin Brown and Hunter, USA. And first place is awarded to Jean LaValle with Cheer, USA. National anthem for the United States of America. And that was our MIDI dog jump high. Congratulations to all the placement winners. Next up is the toy division. Our 12-inch dogs in third place for the bronze medal is Christine Redeker with Toy Poodle Giddy Up, Team Canada. And in second place, our silver medalist is Crackers with Andy Mueller, USA. First place and the gold medal goes to Tangle with Dana Pike, USA. And now the national anthem for the United States of America. Thank you.